Hi, I'm Dr. Young. In this video, we will focus on the distribution of income and how income inequality is measured. Income inequality is the disparity in the distribution of income between individuals, groups, populations, or social classes. Let's begin by presenting some recent stats about income distribution in the U.S. and the world. According to the Census Bureau and the Tax Policy Center, almost all quintiles of the U.S. income distribution have been growing since 2016. This table shows the upper limit and mean of each quintile group of U.S. household income from 2016 to 2020. Each quintile consists of 20% of U.S. households. For instance, the lowest quintile represents U.S. households from 0 to the 20th percentile. On the other hand, the top quintile consists of the top 20th percent of U.S. households. Note, the only year with a decrease in household income across all quintiles is 2020. The pandemic will do that to you. Income inequality in the U.S. can easily be seen in the table. Take 2020 as an example. Households in the top quintile have a mean income of over $250,000, which is more than 17 times the mean household income in the lowest quintile. Even for households in the middle quintile, which are largely considered as the middle class, the mean income in the top quintile is still almost four times higher. One key question about income inequality is how countries and societies can do better about poverty. In order to study this question, we need to first define measures of poverty. One popular measure of income inequality is the poverty rate, which is the percentage of households in a country that has family income below a certain threshold. In the U.S., the threshold is set by the federal government, which we call the poverty line. The poverty line depends on the number of persons in the household. For example, the poverty line for 2021 for a one-person household is $12,880 per year. The poverty line for a three-person household is $21,960 per year. In the same year, the U.S. poverty rate was 11.6%, which translates to almost 38 million people in poverty, according to the U.S. Census Bureau. The poverty rate varies among different groups of society. For instance, the older population is less likely on average to be below the poverty line. The poverty rate of female households without a spouse present is about five times higher than that of married couple families. As we have seen so far, statistics from the Census Bureau provide information on the income distribution and poverty rates of the American households. However, there are certain aspects that are less straightforward to interpret from these numbers. Let's briefly discuss a few problems in measuring income inequality using the traditional methods. First, the stats we reviewed in the previous sections are a household's family income. By definition, these measures do not account for non-monetary items. For instance, free food or medical services that are transferred to the low-income population do not appear in these tables. Economists call these kinds of transfers in-kind transfers. Second, income changes as people age. Younger cohorts that are in school or in professional training are likely to have low or negative income. Thus, young people tend to borrow and pay off debt over their lifetime. Some examples here include student loans or mortgages. Therefore, using monetary income as a measurement of poverty does not necessarily equate to standard of living. Third, random events can distort household income. For instance, winning the lottery may give a decent boost to household income for 1 year, but one should not expect to win the lottery every year. In economics, this is the difference between transitory income, which is lottery winnings, and permanent income, which is the household's normal income. Therefore, it is important that we measure poverty on a household's permanent income, not total annual income, which includes both transitory and permanent income. So while income inequality is an important social issue that can be gauged by studying income distribution and the poverty rate, these measures may not paint a complete picture. If you want to explore these topics more in depth, come visit us at Chegg, where you can see additional topic videos and solved example problems. Or you can ask one of the Chegg subject matter experts.